Hi everyone. These are grim days that we are seeing. I'm sorry I couldn't be around too often because I've also been extremely busy. We've been hit by a tsunami that is the second wave of COVID-19, and it is, if we thought last year was bad, this time is almost five times worse. Most of the people that are testing positive are going to be home isolating. So today we're going to talk about a few tips that we use and things that you need to be vigilant about if you are home isolating. Now, who is asked to home isolate? Quarantine is for people with asymptomatic illness, meaning you have absolutely no symptoms, but you are COVID positive. If you have mild symptoms like a loss of sense of smell or a distorted sense of smell this time around, or a distorted sense of taste, if you have a cold, mild cough, slight fever, these are all mild symptoms. Moderate to severe disease, we are trying to hospitalize when and however is available. So things that you need to look out for if you are recommended home isolation by your doctors. First and foremost, when you see your COVID report positive, don't panic. They may ask you to get a CT scan also. All of these is to monitor the extent of the disease in your body. There is nothing to panic about. If you do, the stress is only going to lower your immunity and make you feel worse about things, which in turn delays your recovery. So please don't panic. I know it's easier said than done, but do try anyway. Secondly, a mild disease could always progress into a moderate or a severe or a critical form of the illness. So you need to stay extremely vigilant if you or your loved one is home isolating with a mild illness. Things that you need to do are something that your doctor would do for you, or that would be done in a hospital, which basically means you have to monitor yourself. Now, what do you have to monitor? Your oxygen saturation, which is your SpO2, your heart rate or your pulse rate. Both of these parameters are known to you by the simple pulse oximeter that you probably all have purchased by now. It'll give you your values, also your temperature. So if your fever was a 99 today, tomorrow if it's progressing to 101, 102, that means there's something wrong. This is getting more serious and we need to keep a watch, or we need to speak to somebody who is medically trained. Now, what happens is, it's better not to go by a single isolated reading. So if your oxygen was a 99 a day before, it's 97, 96, 94. We can see it before it turns to a 94 directly. We see a gradual fall in the trend. You know, there's a downward trend that we note, which is why it's important to chart. Now, I usually ask my patients to coincide the charting and their meals, because the meals remind you to chart and the charting reminds you to eat. You know, because of the stress, because of the disease, nowadays because of a loss of a sense of smell and taste also, you probably would lose your appetite, which is natural, but it is very, very important that you keep eating. Try eating, you know, high protein foods, a lot of fruits. Hydrate yourself very, very well. This is extremely important in your recovery. So keep eating, keep hydrating yourself. Hydration is the most important thing here. Plenty of fluids, more than what you normally require, because you will be dehydrated. One, because of the illness, because of the fever. Also, it's extremely hot outside, so the weather also will promote dehydration. So take care of yourselves in that aspect. Simple medicines are all that you're going to need in this form of the illness. You don't need the remdesivir and, you know, oxygen. Nothing of that. You'll just need basic paracetamol or Crocin or a Dolo, multivitamins, and that's about it. Your doctors might prescribe an antibiotic that is to prevent secondary infections over this viral disease. That's all. It's just prophylactic antibiotics. You don't need anything more than that. Something I recommend to my patients, and this has helped in almost 99% of recovery in all of my patients, is deep breathing exercises. Now, what do I mean when I say deep breathing? Not pranayam. Please understand. Pranayam is rapid, shallow breathing. This is slow, deep, full breathing to open up your lungs basically and, you know, push in oxygen and air into it. So this is one deep breath which you're going to take in slowly and hold. So one breath over 5 seconds. That's a long time. Okay, so that means 12 breaths in 1 minute. Do this one full minute of 12 breaths sitting, the next minute in the lying down position, supine position. Okay, so 12 breaths lying down, and the third minute will be 12 breaths in a prone position, which means you're lying down but on your tummy. This helps aerate your lungs well and will, you know, build up the oxygen levels in your body also. So try doing this at the same four times that you're charting. You can chart and then you can do this and then have your meals. Don't do the deep breathing on a full stomach, preferably. You might, you know, feel a little full, you might pull up, you might feel a little like you're regurgitating a little bit. So if you have to do it more often, do it 2 hours after your meal or before your meal, not immediately after your meal. All right. Other exercises. A lot of people have asked me if they can continue exercising because, you know, hey, we feel fine, nothing is happening to us, we're just stuck at home, can we continue exercising? Light to moderate exercise is fine. Mild forms of yoga are fine. Power yoga, lifting weights, going for a run is not recommended. Please understand, your body is under physical stress. Okay, this is not your routine self. So treat yourself like a patient. Mild forms of exercise are fine. Sometimes, because of the fatigue and the body ache that this illness brings with it, even regular household chores, people do find them difficult, you know. So it's not easy, and I don't recommend it. Your body needs a lot of rest. So mild forms of exercise are okay. Heavy exercise, rigorous exercises are absolutely not recommended. Rest. It is extremely important that you rest during this period. All right, your body has to recover. So good nutrition, basic medicines, and a lot of rest and hydration. That is what you need to get out of this mild illness. At least 8 to 10 hours of sleep at night. Rest in the day also if you have to. It is really going to help you get out of this. All right. The last and the most important bit is keeping yourself happy, thinking positive thoughts. I know you're going to think I'm stupid for saying this, but I'm a firm believer that your mental and physical health go hand in hand. You cannot recover from a physical illness if you're constantly stressing, thinking negative thoughts. It impacts your recovery. Believe me, I have a lot of studies, and I'm in the process of studying, you know, conducting various studies linking mental and physical health. So it is very important that you do whatever it takes, any hobby that you enjoy, talk to people that you love, read a book, watch a show, Netflix, whatever gets you through. Think happy thoughts. Believe firmly that you are going to get well. Nothing is going to get in the way of you getting out of this illness. And when you do believe that, you're going to get through. Trust me. There are a lot of questions that we have gotten regarding the protocols that have been published by a lot of newspapers, by a lot of media outlets, on a lot of social media channels also. Everybody has been printing out these protocols for treatment of COVID. So everyone seems to know, for asymptomatic illness, give these medicines, for mild this, for moderate this, for critical this, for severe. You know, the flowchart has been shared by a lot of people. Some people are also recommending steroids. You know, Instagram is full of these things. Steroids, yes, they do help. There are a lot of studies that say that they are very effective in treating moderate to severe diseases. Now, in mild forms, what happens is, or in any form for that matter, what happens is steroids have to be given at the right time and the right dose. These are extremely good drugs when used at the right time. If used at the wrong time, they can cause more harm than good. So in case you have prescribed steroids, or your pharmacist or a non-medical person has prescribed steroids to you, be careful, be vigilant, consult your doctor or any registered medical practitioner before taking them, and understand when they have to be given, when not. I'll explain this maybe in a later video, but this is something that is extremely important. We are facing a crisis of sorts, I do understand. And even for people who don't have COVID and who are stuck at home because of the lockdown, I know this is a very difficult time for all of you, for all of us in general. Everybody's mental health has been impacted. You know, we feel helpless, we feel hopeless. And these are two major signs that lead into depression, honestly, clinically. So I do understand what you're going through. If you do need any kind of assistance at all, if you need somebody to talk to, we are always here listening to what you have to say. Drop us a mail at iamlistening@thesafetynet.in. We are here to help you. Yes, everybody is overwhelmed, so are we, but we are doing our best and we promise you, we will be there exactly when you need us. Don't worry about a thing. Until our next video, do stay safe, do stay healthy, do write into us. We are thesafetynet.in on Instagram, Facebook, and YouTube. Until next time, see you. Stay strong.